strong, limited, marginalized by DOJ officials, as well as other U.S.
Hi guys, welcome back to XCOM 2, War of the Chosen. We got the, let's see. Covert infiltration, that's it, yeah. That's the word I was looking for. Welcome back to XCOM 2, War of the Chosen. Covert infiltration, yes. Excellent. Okay. Let's load her up. One day on the power coil. Shit. Okay, I need supplies. Can't pass up an engineer. I like engineers.
They put me in a corner, and the the latest is that they told me that I had to choose to either step down or to resign. I'm counting on the whistleblower protection laws and also special counsel to.
Why did they ask you to take a lower position or resign? What was their reason?
7 days.
Part of this whole effort to retaliate against me. They several times. The Office of Special Counsel is where you go through the federal FBI to bring allegations of retaliation and investigate it, and then we'll take this to the Merit Systems Protection Board, civil court, which will determine their liability.
Joseph, are you able to do your job at the IRS this day?
I've gone through a massive depressive state. I mean, it's hard. I'm isolated. It's marginalized. I'm investigations I can conduct. And I've lost personal relationships. I've lost a lot of things. But again, at the end of the day, I'm an honest person. I think I'm going to get my belief in me as well. I would have done it again over and over again. And it wasn't one of the segments of Gary and I actually signing it back. We have defamation lawsuits, literally. And it's a way that we can get back. And we have a big group around us that support whistleblowers. Gary and I are on a government salary. We're doing this. Very limited amount of, like, we don't make much money
or not.
And we have
to.
Shit, no.
Good luck to you. We'll be watching. It takes a lot of courage to stand up and do what you both did. And we appreciate you being open and candid with us here today. Thank you so much. And just a pleasure. It's good to see you both. Take care.
I've got two scrappers.
So now, something a little different on the story and the show today. Jonathan Rumi, who you know plays Jesus in the biblical blockbuster series, The
Chosen. Wing Templar in here.
A message to all of us about the power of prayer this holiday season on day one of Advent.
It can be so easy to get busy and distracted by the holidays. Our inspiration is easy
to lose sight of
his
If you need cash, the last thing you want to do is spend cash just to see if you qualify for a loan. Yet some lenders charge you hundreds of dollars.
Alloy Shield. Plated Templar armor, good. We have to buy all these. Predator armor.
If you have a life insurance policy you no longer need, now you can sell your policy, even a term policy, for an immediate cash payment.
We thought we had planned carefully for our retirement.
But we quickly realized we needed a way to supplement our income.
If you have $100,000 or more of life insurance, you may qualify to sell your policy. Don't cancel or let your policy lapse without finding out what it's worth. Visit CoventryDirect.com to find out if your policy qualifies. Or call 1-800-515-4100. Coventry Direct, you need to find your insurance.
Okay.
All day distributing college football on your TV.
Speaking of, Frank, run a snacks and bowl of chips. Body, but you need to sauce. What are you going to do? Don't question the coach.
The supplement I like to take is Balance of Nature. I recommend it to a lot of my friends. And I said, don't talk about what hurts you. Talk about what you can do to make you feel better. And how I feel better is exercise, fruits and vegetables, and then take Balance of Nature because it's helped me.
Get 50% off your first preferred set with free shipping and our money back guarantee as a new preferred customer by using discount code Fox News.
When your business throws you a surprise, don't throw it out. The funding you can count on is Duke Road makes it simple and convenient to solve problems you never saw coming. With troubled roots, Biz Duke Credit is the solution. Biz Duke Credit, funding that's next.
Humana Medicare Advantage Plans. Carry this card and you can have the power to unlock benefits beyond Original Medicare. These are convenient plans that offer all of the benefits of Original Medicare plus extra coverage and benefits. With a Humana Medicare Advantage plan, you get doctor, hospital, and prescription drug coverage in one convenient plan. With $0 copays on hundreds of prescriptions, most plans include dental coverage, including $0 copays for covered preventive services, vision coverage with eye exams, and an allowance for eye work, even hearing benefits with routine hearing exams and coverage toward hearing aids. That's more than you get with original Medicare, but it gets even better because Humana offers $0 or low monthly plan premiums. You'll also get $0 copays for routine vaccines at in-network retail pharmacies, $0 copays for telehealth visits, $0 copays for in-network preventive services, plus worldwide coverage for emergency and urgent care when you travel. And Medicare Advantage plans ensure your covered medical costs, including all doctor and emergency care, will never go above a maximum out-of-pocket amount if you know beforehand. Imagine benefits like these in one convenient plan. Plus, you'll have access to Humana's multiple large plan networks of doctors, hospitals, and pharmacies. So if you want more from Medicare, call now to see if there's a plan in your area that could give you extra coverage and benefits, including coverage for doctor, hospital, and prescription drugs, plus a cap on your out-of-pocket medical costs. And most plans include coverage for dental, vision, even hearing. A knowledgeable, licensed Humana sales agent will explain your coverage options, even help you enroll over the phone. Call today, and we'll also send out a free guide. But now is the time. The annual enrollment period ends December 7th. Humana, a more human way to healthcare.
So Christmas is 3 weeks away, not 3 days away. And Hallo is kicking off the Advent Pray 25 Challenge today, which I'm going to be part of.
Okay.
For this Advent is John 3:16. It reminds us, for God so loved the world that he gave his only Son, so that everyone who believes in him might not perish, but might have eternal life.
Actor and narrator Jonathan Lee is here. He, of course, plays Jesus in the huge hit series The Chosen, season 5 coming up in April, and in the Hallo spokesperson. Jonathan, it's so good to see you again. Thank you for joining us and happy Advent. You know, this is the kind of thing that people see John 3:16 over and over again. I see on this football comment and signs in our backyard. But tell us why this is such a really breathtaking part of the gospel.
You know, the Christmas story is not just about Christmas trees.
Okay, we got the lost here.
Its core is about vulnerability.
All lost. Good. This will be good.
God, the very flesh of Jesus, as a babe, to live by one of us, to eat, to breathe, to have friends, to argue, to fall, to skin his knee, to go to parties, to weddings with his family, and everything we need. And live the life of a human, a sinless life for us, being a son of God, so that we have an ally throughout our trials and tribulations and struggles that can identify with us. And so we have to go to him. I think that was the epitome. But it all starts in the Advent himself. So it's going to be profoundly moving and impactful challenge.
Well, I've been texting my family and my group chat, like, oh, guess what, 3:25 is because to me, it's a way to do exactly.
Invest on some of these guys here.
They're short, like 8 to 10 minutes. And you get to pray with Jonathan and with Bear Grylls.
Bear Grylls. Just an outdoors spiritual experience. And he does a wonderful job narrating
shit.
Just about this couple that go through these challenges, pre-relationship to Jesus, then discovering Jesus and having this intense relationship, and then having their lives take these crazy left turns, and how they navigate it through faith with a mentor like C.S. Lewis, who's part of their journey. And so Bear is reading from the book, I'm Helping You with Meditation, and he's just one of the myriad of guests that we have joined us for this challenge. We've got musicians, Gwen Stefani,
Bagel, Pastor Prentice Chandler, it's just Kevin James, so it's just, I'm so excited. I'm personally able to see it. There's probably going to be millions of people who join this community once it gets up and running, and you're sort of praying other people in there who you don't know in these, short periods of the day. Do you go through it yourself?
This is
this meditation will be one of several that I already do, like night prayers, I do daily meditations, I pray rosary, I do. There's so much that just reflection, the gospel, every day, Jeff Cato's religion. So there's so much that I already use this app for. Like it's kind of
good. Yeah. And I just get out of it, you know, in the morning, in the evening, other way before, and it's just so beautiful.
It's so simple to just have prayer of each day and to God in a way that it's, you know, epic.
Jonathan, thank you. It's great to see you. 325 on Hallows. Have you downloaded the app? Super easy. It's wonderful to see you. And listen to our podcast. We've been talking about season 5 of The Chosen, which I know we're all really looking forward to. And it's great. All the big things. Great to see you. So, quick salute to a good friend of ours, World War II veteran, Stephen Melnikoff, on the beach of Normandy. The day after D-Day, he died on 2 Purple Hearts and 3 Bronze Stars in combat. I was so honored to speak with him in Normandy back in June when we were all there for the 80th anniversary of Operation Overlord. And he told me about getting wounded in a battle less than 2 weeks after the invasion.
That day, I was hit. I was shot the next year by the G-Bone. And I don't know how possible to keep it all with the world.
Excellent.
You hit me, and he moved the gun on you, so I get in there, and I got on my back. I finished my room with my kid, and after they moved on, I walked my way back to the medical station.
So Steve
Miller,
at that point, was 104. He turned
105
in 1995 on Thanksgiving Day, so we thank him for his service. We thank his family, all of America's heroes, for their service and sacrifice. And we thank you for being with us today on the story. And this is the story of the past. I will be back here at 3 o'clock tomorrow. But stick around because there will be beg your pardon. Fierce reaction on Capitol Hill today after President Joe Biden pardons his son Hunter after repeatedly saying he wouldn't. What is possible by Donald Trump's attorney general?
Thank you.
Casey.
All right, busy day there. Rich Edson, thank you. Lawmaker meanwhile, including some Democrats, are ripping the president's pardon, and it comes to President-elect Trump's pick for Attorney General Ken Bondi is it the hill. Chuck Berger is in the middle of the action. He's got the latest for us. Hi, Chuck.
Senator, good afternoon. There's serious bipartisan backlash. We told Republican Mike Lee, who says he wants Hunter Biden to testify at a hearing. Democrat Michael Bennett accused the president of putting both personal interests ahead of duty. The GOP pulled no punches.
We are known to them.
Joe Biden is a baffling liar. He's been lying for 40 years. What makes you think he's not lying about his son, for God's sakes? And so this is not a surprise to me.
Some of the Democrats believe that he is substantial. Vermont Democrat Peter Welch called the pardon unwise. Ohio Democrat Greg Landsman said, quote, as a father, I get it. But Landsman added, it's a setback for those who might be able to again believe in public service. Republicans are human.
Joe Biden, for 50 years in public office, has always pridefully boasted about this work as a Biden. Trash. For months, he and his spokespersons promised the American people they wouldn't pardon Hunter Biden.
Also on Capitol Hill today, Attorney General nominee Tom Bondi and incoming Judiciary Committee Chairman Chuck Grassley. Now, Bondi meets next hour with Lindsey Graham. He also met today with UN Ambassador nominee Evan Stefanik and Defense Secretary nominee Pete Hegseth.
Nice.
Professor and former Deputy Assistant Attorney General John Yu. John, to you first. What is your reaction to this? What should people think about it?
I'm sad to say this is an ignominious end to a failed presidency. The founders clearly gave the president the power to pardon whoever he wanted of federal crimes. But the purpose of the pardon power is either to break up conspiracies against the United States. President Biden's claims that this is selective prosecution don't hold any water. For example, Hunter Biden was convicted by a jury of his peers in Delaware. He pled guilty to wide-ranging tax fraud and evasion. And most importantly, he was prosecuted by the Justice Department, at which his father sits at the head. The president, Joe Biden, is the chief law enforcement officer of the United States. If he's accusing anyone of vindictive prosecution, it's himself. The reason I think this is sad is that it's President Biden showing, I think,
okay,
that the American people rejected the Biden-Harris administration in these last elections. Here's a president who accused Trump of being a liar, yet here Biden broke his fundamental commitment to the American people. He's accused Trump of meddling with the justice system. Here, Biden is meddling with the justice system. Yeah. He's accused Trump of putting his family first, and here he's put his own family first.
I mean, to John's point, I mean, not only did he say over and over and over again that he would not pardon his son, and here he is in fact, but he claims that his son was targeted just because his last name was Biden. Selective prosecution, as John just said.
Senator, this is total disrespect for the American people and total disrespect for the rule of law. I would say that the last few years have just been a massive waste of time from all the prosecutors and investigators and whistleblowers who put in time to bring Hunter Biden to justice. But it's much worse than a waste of time, because at the end of the day, this is going to undermine people's faith in the system, the idea that the rule of law can be applied fairly and partially neutral in the United States. To John's point and your point, obviously this was not a selective, unfair prosecution. This is a prosecution that was supervised and carried out by an independent special counsel, as well as by Biden's own Justice Department.
And keep in mind, there are hundreds, probably thousands of people out there who also represent requests for pardon, saying that they
Purifier. I hate these guys. I hate firing this. Welcome. Oh, you nailed them. Good. I can claymore your ass. Shit.
Order.
Still, you nailed them.
Including my classic standard, my pill is only 14 EVA. But that's not all. I'm so confident you're going to love our classic my pillows that I'm going to extend my 60-day money-back guarantee until March 1st, 2025. Plus, orders over $75 ship absolutely free.
Sure, tells it like it is. Get his take on Addiction's Hot Button Topics.
On the show, we always want to set the record straight.
You can't miss anything. Thanks a lot.
I am. Okay.
Trudeau has appointed Canada's Globe and Mail offering to deploy helicopters and drones to eat things up.
public threat for the social media posting was on Monday evening. 4 days later, he was at his residence in Florida.
Fuck.
Having dinner to talk about exactly that context.
Trump allies on Capitol Hill believe the president's approach will be tough, but ultimately pretty simple.
What you're going to see is basically the kind of diplomacy of rock, paper, scissors. It is strength, weakness, appeasement, and strength wins. They know Donald Trump is a strong leader. They know if he says he's going to sanction you, if he's going to hold you to accountable, he is going to do that. That's why you saw Justin Trudeau fly to Palm Beach to meet with President Trump.
He's a quiet poor man transitioned down there in the Palm Beaches. Ted Cruz saw a big motorcade sneaking through the streets a few hours ago, but no public events. Sandra.
I will keep watching for that. Peter Ducey, thank you. So, current war starts hanging up. Is this how we get more done as tariff fronts get world leaders to the table? Let's get the read from the guy who knows about it. What about making deals? Captain O'Leary, Terry Rubber, Leary Matthews, and Shark Tank, you're back there. Kevin, great to see you.
Nice shot.
Totally obsessed. We love to watch you make a deal. So, is the hope that this is how you get deals done, Kevin?
Yes, it's an important development, but it is China, Mexico, and Canada are completely different in this respect. We know with certainty we're going into NAFTA free negotiations. And Trump is smart about this. He's obviously engaged both leaders of both countries. There are different problems in each place. Canada is a huge trading partner, particularly in energy. A huge percentage of energy imported in the U.S. if you get energy independence comes from Canada, particularly from Alberta, Saskatchewan, and British Columbia. So that's part of the negotiation of national trade. I think he's positioned. Now, the complexity of the Canadian situation is this. Justin Trudeau is quiet in the fact there in Canada. He's been there a long time in the parliamentary system, just like Britain. If you have a prime minister that can't deliver a majority mandate, it's like a piece of old moldy cheese in the fridge. You want to get rid of it. And that's what's going on within his own party. He's surviving these votes. There's another one today at 4 o'clock. They'll probably survive. This is a non-confidence vote. That's how they do in the parliamentary system, to throw the bomb out, so to speak. But he won't use that until around February 15th. So my
question
is, it won't be Trudeau negotiating with Trump when he's finally in power after January 20th. It's going to be someone else. And I think Trump is smarter. So this isn't a long show going right now, but it's just showing you how powerful he is. Just to point out, this is policy by social media, and he's got leaders sparing them out. He won't be going. He's got that good cold weather. He just stays in the water.
Fuck. Let's see if I can move him away.
Just seems like these markets keep going up and up and up, and we, yeah, record highs yet again, Kevin.
Yes, because two things have been settled. Number one, there's not going to be a massive change to tax policy at the corporate level. Remember, the true ideology is going to be less than 28%, which has never been done before, to go from 21 to 28 in the swoop of a pen. That would have been a disastrous recipe earnings. That's off the table. Now we're talking about expanding the Trump tax credits, so we've got stability there. But the one that hasn't gotten enough credit yet is everybody in small or large companies today understand that the regulatory environment is going to be just the way. And that gives you so much more confidence. Before, in the small businesses that I work with and the large ones, we'll go ahead and open that plant. We'll go ahead and do CapEx expenses. We'll hire that person because we know the regulatory environment's going to be better.
For such a great point. And obviously, lower taxes, part of the discussion, and rolling back those regulations. This is from the environment. It always works. Kevin, great to see you. Thank you so much for coming on.
Take care.
All right. Hunter Biden, you know, off the hook, and so is reaction on Capitol Hill. We'll have lawmakers on both sides of the aisle. But first, to New York City, where the fate of Daniel Penny hangs in the balance, before legal teams have to say if closing arguments are underway.
I need more ammo.
For God so loved the world that he gave his only son, so that everyone who believes in him might not perish, but might have eternal life.
Over 16,000 USPS employees working in sync to ensure everything sits on its holiday drive ends with a moment of joy.
Oh shit, wrong way, man.
Generalized by Athenian graphics. Picture what life could look like with New Dark Hytrulo. A subcutaneous injection that takes about 30 to 90 seconds. For one thing, could it get more time to do? Vivgard Hytrulo can improve daily abilities and reduce muscle weakness with a treatment plan that's personalized to you. Do not use Vivgard Hytrulo if you have a serious allergy to any of its ingredients. It can cause serious allergic reactions like trouble breathing and decrease in blood pressure leading to fainting, and allergic reactions such as rashes, swelling under the skin, shortness of breath, and the most common side effects are respiratory and urinary tract infections, headache, and injection site reactions. It may increase the risk of infusion-related reactions and infections.
Are you fucking serious, man? You can't be fucking serious. Holy fuck. One shot out of nowhere. Like, fuck off.
As a physician in the mid-80s, I was driven by a deep desire to make a profound difference in my patients' lives. That passion led me to start Balance of Nature. In over 30 years of phytochemical research, I have yet to find a more effective way of preserving the color, taste, and smell of whole fruits and vegetables. There's a reason Balance of Nature is in a capsule. There's a reason why we use a specific variety of fruit and vegetable ingredients in our products. I encourage you to open the capsules, see, smell, and taste the difference. Experience for yourself the power of whole food ingredients and make Balance of Nature part of your daily life.
Get 50% off your first preferred set with free shipping and our money back guarantee as a new preferred customer by using discount code FOXNEWS. A massive storm burying parts of the Great Lakes region under more than 6 feet of snow. 6 feet! And it's not over yet. We are back in 60 seconds.
There's some things that work better together, like your workplace benefits and retirement savings. Gloria helps you choose the right amounts with our over 100 best benefits across all your benefits and savings options, so you can feel confident in your financial choices.
they really know how to put two and two together. Foil, well planned, well invested, well protected. A BC Bond Denture Adhesive Seals hold all day and make your gums feel happier. With incredible release technology, strong all day hold, and a cushiony soft seal, full gum protection and comfort. Strong all day hold makes your gums happy. See Bond. Looking for a moisturizer that does more than just moisturize? Try Olay Regenerative for 10 benefits in every jar. Olay visibly firms, lifts, and smooths wrinkles by penetrating the skin to boost regeneration at the surface cellular level. Try Olay. The Daniel Penny trial now. We're closing arguments all underway. Fox News' CB Cotton has the very latest from New York City for us. Another big day with all of this. Where do things stand, CB?
Bystander, most definitely, where prosecutors are giving their closing arguments, arguing and saying, telling jurors, there's no disputing that when Gordon Neely got on the subway last year, subway riders were very frightened. But they said, going back from Daniel Penny, kept his chokehold for far too long. So they're arguing to jurors that Penny's initial chokehold was justified, but became unjustified when he continued his hold on Neely after the subway doors opened and passengers were free to leave. Several eyewitnesses testified that Neely was making threats on the train, but the assistant district attorney said it wasn't reasonable for Penny to believe Neely would act on those threats, telling jurors, quote, our society cannot allow others to kill people based on empty threats, end quote. And reminding them that this case is about whether Penny was reckless. Earlier today, though, the defense gave its closing statements, reminding jurors that several eyewitnesses felt relieved when Penny stepped up and were playing statements like this on Body Cam video. Defense attorney Stephen Rayford said it's no coincidence they only have this video of Daniel Penny's restraint. He said that's because it's the only time people felt safe enough to take out their phone. And he used the widely circulated video to argue to jurors that Penny only kept holding the restraint because Neely kept fighting back. He's also argued the prosecution has not proven that Penny kept squeezing up until the moment he let go of Neely. And he reminded jurors of the defense expert who said the chokehold did not kill Neely, but rather the combined effects of a genetic condition, synthetic marijuana use, schizophrenia, and exertion during the struggle. So because today's proceedings began late, Sandra, is likely that jurors will not begin deliberations until tomorrow.
Back to you. And we'll be watching on the CB Cotton here in New York City for us. Thank you, CB. So that was our next guest, see all this time. Defense attorney and Fox News contributor Ted Williams joins us now. Ted, great to see you. So based on what you heard in that court, where do you see this going?
You know, Sandra, it's very difficult to say where in what direction this case is going. We do know that the prosecution's case primarily is that Daniel Penny held Jordan Neely for 6 minutes and that was too long. But then when we look at the defense's case that they put on, and they put on witnesses to say that Mr. Neely was acting up, that they were in fear of harm, and that Jordan Penny acted as a good Samaritan. And under the good Samaritan law, as long as he was acting with good faith, and that he was not...
Hey, Gizmo, how are you?
Certainly will. You have to take into consideration, and I'm sure that the jury will,
that Mr. Mealy are suffering from schizophrenia. He was mentally ill, that he had drugs in his system, and that he had a long, extensive criminal record. Quite naturally, Daniel Penny did not know those things, but those are things that clearly would have been brought to the jury to try to put everything in some kind of a cohesive manner of circumstance as to why certain things took place the way they did.
Got it. Ted Williams, thank you very much for joining us. All right, we'll see what happens tomorrow. Back to the fallout after President Joe Biden pardons his son Hunter. Reaction from both sides coming up. But first, Snow Gary Gregory, please review all of our Garrison's touch plunging. For millions, how long will the blast last? And good time to stay inside and shop, of course, and have a budget for those rules. But what's the deal for overall sales so far this season? We are on.
I get your food, boys.
To access Medicare Advantage's largest national network of providers.
Now, if you have any of these chronic conditions, be sure to ask about United Healthcare's chronic specialty expert.
They got their shields on.
Call or click to connect with United Healthcare today about the only Medicare Advantage plans with the AAR today. The coverage you can get for your whole life ahead.
So imagine 6 feet of snow in some of these taller than most people. It is very windy in the Great Lakes region right now. The fierce storm sends temperatures hovering across the western millions. That's a read around about that very latest sun. All the authorities is going to last because some people are really getting mad.
It is taking really long, so these numbers are almost hard to believe. These are some of the so far storms out of Lake Ontario. Venture there in New York is 60 to 65 inches there on the high end. Those are the higher storms you fly, but that's what they're doing. It's really impressive numbers, anywhere from 50 getting up to 60 inches as well. This has been a large system that we continue to see kind of moving across this region. What actually ends up happening is you've got some really frigid air. The folks are not seeing the snow, a problem in those that are eastern half the country. It runs over days of the warm lake water that picks up that snow and starts to drop it. Unfortunately, it is still continuing to come down. We've seen a little bit of shift in the wind direction here between some of the areas that have gotten hit, might shift just a little bit, but still lake effect snow warnings in place across the of Lake Ontario as well. So the snow is going to continue to fall. This lasts at least through the middle of the week. And then we've got a secondary system we're watching. This is a little bit of a clipper system that's going to run back over the lakes. It does mean snow for the lakes, but this is not strictly a lake effect snow system. This one actually will bring snow to a little bit wider area. So even though it's going to really pull across the coastline, finally it's going to come with a little bit more snow. This is ultimately how that plays out. It is still the heaviest thing right along the lakes.
Let's save this. I'm going to see you guys on the next one. All right, peace.